with 20 points, 10 rebounds. Just
yeah, for a huge stretch in the second half, it seemed like she got every rebound defensively for us. And some of those offensive calls when she was getting after those rebounds, those are just tough calls. I mean, she's reaching out of her area, getting her hands on stuff. And when she's got a bounce in her step and plays with that level of energy like she does tonight, I think she's a tremendous post player, and she's only going to get better and better for us.
Tennessee State shot better than you guys from the field, but you did a good job limiting their possessions with forcing 25 turnovers and also with 39 rebounds, 24 defensive, 15 offensive. So
yeah,
played a big part in this game.
Well, our two keys, you know, for the game were to beat them on the boards. And we felt like if we were even on the boards or they out-rebounded us, we probably weren't going to win. So that was a huge emphasis, as well as converting off of those turnovers. They were averaging 20 coming in, and we felt like if that's what they average, then they should have more against us just with the way we play. So we've really been working on converting in practice when we do force people into turnovers. And I think our team is having fun with it. They're playing it a lot more aggressively when we get stops. And when we get turnovers, so now in turn when we get rebounds, it's the same thing. They're really being aggressive off of the rebounds and pushing tempo, which is it's tough to guard, I think, for 40 straight minutes when people are constantly pushing it back at you at the other end.
I know earlier in the season started out slow before you beat Austin Peay and SLU, and then entered that other, you know, tough stretch. And as you said, the team finally got it together after the Austin Peay game, and then kind of over break things slid over a little bit. So now two wins in a row. Still got to work hard on it, but getting back on track.
Absolutely, I feel like after the Murray State game, we had 2 days of practice that weren't very good, and since then we haven't had a bad day of practice. And I think I would like to say that they finally understand like how they have to practice day in and day out to win games, but they're going to be the ones that prove that. I don't know that for sure yet. I hope that's the case. But up until this point, we've been so inconsistent. Just who's going to show up each game? Who's going to play well for us? And it starts in practice. You can't have bad practices and expect to play consistent night in, night out in games. So hopefully our team has turned the corner a little bit, and we can just build on this. And we just keep, as a staff, focusing them one game at a time. And now it's on to Eastern Kentucky. And these games, they don't matter when we play Eastern Kentucky. All that matters is Eastern Kentucky on Monday. And then when we go to Moorhead the next game, that's all that matters after that.
You know, I thought it was real important to have a lead at halftime, because these guys are 2-8.
Mm-hmm.
We're losing first half.
Mm-hmm.
And I thought the key to that was when you went into that zone, which you're probably going to have, you're going to be using a lot more on this.
Yeah.
It was the play of Kenner.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, she did not took that passing lane away two or three times in a row there towards the end of the first half.
Yeah.
We got buckets off of that. I thought that was key.
Yeah. And she's been fantastic in both of these wins. Just she's all over the place. And she does a lot of intangibles that don't show up in the stat sheet. And I agree. I thought if we let them hang around, they're extremely dangerous, because that press, if they get a tip or something, easy basket, you can't make it, let it be close, because it comes down to 2-3 points, and they get something easy, they could very, very easily be on the other side of that. So I thought we did a good job of just doing enough. There were points when I thought we needed to put them away, get it to 10, get it to 15, and that'll come with winning, I think, learning how to do that. Right now, to keep it at 7 points pretty much the whole second half, again, that's something I don't know that we could have done earlier in the season. So I think we're getting better, and we'll continue to get better.
There's a little bit of a momentum swing there in the first half. They were up 15-8, and the game was kind of dragging along a little bit, and then you go on a 9-2 run, and all of a sudden, from there on, it's all you guys.
And it was about getting stops. We gave them, three easy baskets in the first 4 minutes, and we had 5 turnovers in the first 4 minutes, and then we only had 5 the rest of the half. So taking care of the ball and getting stops defensively really, I thought, turned the tide in our favor.